January is Cancer Awareness Month for cervical cancer. We all know that cervix is a part of uterus, and the cervical cancer is more common in rural areas. In urban areas, the uterine cancer is more common. But I am happy that cervical cancer is coming less and less, down and down. The incidence is reducing because of lot of activities that our health care facility and healthcare provider, they are taking. Even a national rural mission or health department of government of India and state government, they are creating awareness about the cervical cancer and doing pap smear and HPV DNAs to detect it in early stage so that we can prevent it and treat it if it is an early stage. So basically, what are the symptoms? These sometimes abnormal bleeding or postcoital bleeding or postmenopausal bleeding, sometimes swelling in the groin. These are some symptoms of cervical cancer. And how doctors treat it? If it is an early stage, then we treat it with the surgery where we remove the complete uterus and surrounding parts and lymph nodes. But if it is little advanced, then we treat it with the chemotherapy and radiation. So best thing is to prevent. How can we prevent the cervical cancer? How can we make it cervical cancer as a history? Yes, first, healthy living, having good exercise, having good diet, balanced diet, keeping away all the addictions, and very, very important is screening. Screening is normally to detect abnormal cells from the uterus, that is called as pap smear test. And second is HPV DNA test, where we take some blood and check it, or also some tissue and check it, because human papillomavirus is one of the most common cause of cervical cancer. And then if we are together bring awareness in the community, in the society, in all the females, in our near and dear ones, I think that would be the great. And very important one good news is now the cervical cancer vaccine is available. Like we all know, corona vaccine. This vaccine can prevent maximum cases of cervical cancer. When we should give it? All the females from 12 to 16, 20 years before their sexual activity start, before their marriage, we all can vaccinate our young kids. And of course, even after marriage also, females can take the cervical cancer vaccine. The doses are simple, 0, 1, 6, and there are very minimal side effects, almost no side effects. So friends, let's create awareness this January month for cervical cancer and uterine cancer. Be vigilant. And if there is any abnormality detected, let us visit our gynecologist or specialist, and vaccination prevent cervical cancer. So let's make the cervical cancer history. Thank you.